All right, guys, Mike Wiedenbach here. The video all about nutrition. To be honest, I didn't think I would have to make this video, but I do. So you know, it is sometimes you are so immersed in a certain topic that you think everybody should know it, but they don't. So talking to clients and so on and so forth, I realized that even though it's 2019, nutrition is still a completely terra incognita, right? I mean, people are still so lost. So let me just try to break down the biggest things you need to know to be successful in terms of creating a physique, okay? So it's going to be a complete rewiring of most people's conception about nutrition. Number one, calories matter most. Period. So we're all humans and we all want a magic portal. We don't want to live in that dreadful world, or maybe we don't live in a dreadful world, but we always think there must be something else, right? There's like Harry Potter's and Hogwarts or Star Wars. So whoosh, we go, right? Now, to lose weight, you need to be in a deficit. Whether you go keto, vegan, intermittent fasting, dinosaur diet, it doesn't matter. You need to be in a deficit. You cannot be eating whatever you want, excess calories, and expect to lose weight. No matter what you're eating, it will not work. Okay, so stop. Now, calories is one thing, but macros are either a split first place or a very close second. Because if I go on a diet and all I eat is gummy bears, I probably lose weight, right? But I'm only eating sugar. And that's probably not such a bright idea. Instead, you gotta hit your macros. So just random examples, your protein, I'm having muscle egg here, but obviously, you know, animal protein, it doesn't matter. Then you gotta hit your carbs. Spätzle, I'm German, can't shake. And then there are your fats, right? So depending on activity level and leanness and physique goal, you gotta figure out your macros. So like if you are trying to lose weight, you should be starting with about 2 grams of protein per pound of body weight, a gram of carbs, 0.5 fat. If you're very, very heavy, you might wanna cut the carbs and narrow that down. But if you're like within reasonable leanness, that should work. Bulking, you would double the carbs and the fats, leave the protein as is, okay? So that's macros. Macros and calories combined with a decent weightlifting program, if you can figure that out, you won. You did it. So what about all the rest that floats around? People say, oh, insulin is making fat, insulin just stop. Insulin just is, okay? So insulin transports nutrients to your muscle cell or the fat cell in some instances. Without insulin, you die. So insulin by itself cannot make you fat because it can only transport what you have eaten. Now what about high insulin levels? Well, that's not a good idea. However, if I eat only 800 calories from this, I will have elevated insulin levels, but I will lose weight. Whereas if I eat only butter, but 5,000 calories, my insulin is not going to go up a whole lot, but I'll be fat, okay? So there's no insulin ferry that comes overnight to your bed and makes the clothes tighter. Doesn't happen. Never will, never has, okay? Cortisol is making me fat, stress making me fat, and boss making me fat. What is cortisol? So cortisol is a hormone that releases, when the body needs adrenaline, glycogen into the bloodstream so you can run away. It fights inflammation, it fights pain. Without cortisol, you die. So sometimes you see like people like Dr. Oz or whatever having a cortisol blocker on TV. If that would work, it would be lethal. You cannot function without cortisol. Now, cortisol by itself also does not make you fat, right? Think about people in war zones or POW camps. they're pretty stressed out. They're about to get killed, beaten, tortured, whatever else, right? But they're super lean. Why? There's a lot of food, okay? So cortisol on its own, having high cortisol levels is not healthy and it's not good for longevity, but it does not cause weight gain. Now, stress-related overeating, that causes weight gain. Point number five, stop obsessing. Over single foods. I don't know if that's a New York thing or whatever it is, but people, they get so hung up on coconut sugar or some weird nut. Hey, it makes no difference, okay? There's no single food that will get you in shape. And there's also no single food that will make you obese unless you overeat that food. So no food, no berry, no nothing will do what proper macros will do for your body. So stop going wild and wasting your money. And then I keep harping on this, but sugar is not the enemy, okay? So there's a strange misconception about sugar. It's processed, it's this, that, the other. Well, it comes from the sugar beet. I think the main issue is when people hear sugar, they think of Monsanto or Kraft foods. Whereas if they hear honey, they think of like a jolly old dude with a belly and a beard who has bees, right? And makes honey. So they're thinking like, oh, the honey, that's healthy, but the sugar is not. Well, chemically, they're pretty much the same substance. Okay, there's like a glucose-fructose mix. And so is everything else, like the agave syrup or even high fructose corn syrup. That's all the same thing. The issue is that it's easy to overconsume, which then, you know, makes you gain weight. But sugar by itself is not unhealthy. Also, where do you draw the line, right? So let's say the ever so humble potato is essentially a really long sugar element, right? Like 300 or whatever atoms tied together, whereas here's only the gummy bear's only like one or two. But again, chemically, we're talking about the same thing. So in conclusion, here's what you have to remember. Your calories matter more than anything else. Your macros matter probably just as much. Insulin just is. It's a transport system that's there. Cortisol helps you work out and fight inflammation and stay alive. It's not evil either. Forget the focus on single foods. And sugar is not the devil either. My God.